Okay, so we're back. One thing I wanted to show you is, it's just as I suspected, we are still in the prologue area. This would be like the Nora lands in Horizon Zero Dawn. And though we kind of did everything in this area, some areas we can only access if there is a specific tool. So without the tool, we cannot access the area. And there are no cauldrons. Cauldrons are the things which let you upgrade your spear so you can, you know, control these machineries. So far, we can control the charges, which I'll show you right now. If I haven't controlled one already. So yesterday I did manage to override a charger when I was playing on my own. I did all the side quests, like you can see. And yeah, that's it. This Vista viewpoint, I have no idea how to do it, but I did this relic thing. The others will get to it when we come to it. Now, we are back in Chains Creek, because there were a couple of quests we could do here. And we are level 8, almost to level 9, by the way. And look there, that little blue icon, blue and white icon, that is an overridden charger. See. Faster than going on foot. And since we've cleared all the bristlebacks in this region, we can finally attend the summit. Embassy. I know there's still a problem with the audio, but we'll get that. Stay here, please. How come the boar could go through that, but when we try to go through it, our health goes through chip damage? Weird, isn't it? Anyway. Look there, more charges. Charges are kinda like rams or bulls, I should say. I should have gone there earlier.
Right, I should find whoever's in charge here. First, I could resupply at my stash. I'd be taking a look around too.
Hold on.
Is that the savior of murder?
Savior. Tell me, are you secret?
I guess I'm not the only one who wants to cut those gates off.
I set up a salvage operation in the hotel. Yes. The camp is a must stop for the serving members looking to trade. Okay. By the looks of it, maybe we are. Okay. Got it. See. Might as well check this out too. Hold on. Where's my mount? In the previous game, we couldn't... I mean, we could override those... T-Rex machines, but... we could not...
Hey, what happened here?
What do you care?
Don't you?
As it happens? No. You know, I was already having a crappy day. You know, these two idiots picked my shift to climb the damn mountain. It wouldn't be so bad if this one weren't so heavy.
Wait, two idiots?
Did I stutter? Yeah, two. I heard another one shouting up top. Then I got caught between sharp claws and sharper fall.
Someone's in trouble. Aren't you gonna do something?
Self-inflicted. And I got my hands full with this one.
You're seriously not going to help.
You seriously are?
Someone's in trouble at the top of the cliff. I better get to climbing.
Stop unnecessarily jumping. I can sometimes see why they would show, why people are saying this game is a bit woke. You know, this might be a controversial topic, but seeing as every single man in this game is either a douchebag or just comparatively weak Aloy, I can see why people would call this game as woke. And this whole...
Get away from me, you bucket of balls!
Things should be stopped by me.
Spot it. Gotta move.
Ah, crap. Wait. Have fun. Really? I won't die. Can't say the same for these fuckers. Everything that is a nail down. Not home. That is the first rule of a JRPG. Any RPG, to be honest.
To miss him. He's dead.
Oh. Guess that's what I get for believing in the first chuff in the tavern who said he was a mountain climbing machine hunter. Oh, at least I don't have to pay him.
What are you doing?
That used to be a signal tower. The mechanism uses a special lens which, in some very specific circles, is highly valuable. And since the Karja are planning on tearing them down, I was going to liberate the lens before it got destroyed. You get it from me, and the lenses from the other towers, I'll make it very worth your while.
You said that was a signal tower.
In its day, it was a sight to see. All six of them, all lit up, all around the domes. They used to warn folks that the Tanaks were coming, for whatever that was worth. As you can imagine, the car just spared no expense putting it together. Hence, the fancy lens is in need of a new home before the towers are torn down.
So the one we scaled yesterday on our own was one of those signal towers.
So...
the Stormbird had crashed in the tower.
I'm more what you'd call an opportunist with a good eye for business. Look, the Karja are going to tear all these towers down anyway. They see no value here. They're trying to make nice with the Tanakh now. See? It's a victimless crime. Opportunity.
Tell that to your friend down there.
Ugh, self-inflicted.
So, yeah,
why can't you do it?
Look, even if I hadn't hurt my uncle here, I'm clearly nowhere near as capable as you. Oh, come on. I can't just let the lenses go to waste. That's not what my father would have wanted.
Stop with the emotional blackmail. Come on, man.
Your father, is he a thief? Sorry. Opportunist, too?
No. He helped design the towers. before he passed on.
So that's how you know about the lenses.
Yeah. And why they have sentimental value.
Now, I think she's not being truthful about it, but
hey. I already found some, actually.
Well, look at that. Looks like you're quite the opportunist, too, eh? Let me take these off your hands.
This should be
a nice reward for your efforts.
What, my dear?
I'm an honest merchant, after all. Thank you.
Aloy.
Reyna. Well, Aloy, as soon as I'm up for it, I'll be going back to Baron Light to rest this ankle. But I'll stick around in case you want to get me that lens of this tower here. No pressure. Just saying. Promise it'll be worth it.
I'll see what I can do.
Somehow I don't think she's telling the truth, but hey.
Okay.
Let's see. Let's fucking dumb as fuck. What the hell?
Okay.
forest, I've got resupply at my stash. We took a look around too.
Did you bring me something good?
Got what you wanted.
Couldn't have done it better myself. Here, for your troubles. You let me know when you find more of these.
I thought there was a power cut or something. Might as well spend the skill points. One for this. And one for this. One more person we need to meet up before. Default clothing from the previous game. Not a send it. Why?
Always open.
We have the rope caster, right? We need this actually. Knockdown, sharp shot. Cool. Is there a table where I can enhance?
Where's Erend? Looks like he's had a few.
Yeah, I'm figuring out a way to get up there.
Savior. You're my last hope.
Conover. She's Meridian Savior, not yours.
It's just Aloy. What do you want?
Please, no one will listen. But the Eclipse... They're here in the Daunt.
Really, Conover? Aloy's the one that defeated them. You're bothering her with this hogwash now?
Some of them must have fled west after the battle at the end. I saw one of our sentries, Lorovic, sneaking off to meet with one. I tried to eavesdrop, but they spotted me. And then Lorovic tried to kill me. Fought back. It was him and me.
Unfortunately, there's no hard evidence that connects Larvik to the Eclipse. And since Conover doesn't deny killing his fellow soldier, Nozar sentenced him to death.
What makes you so sure Larvik was working with the Eclipse?
Well, I was too far to hear with them. But I heard them both say the word Eclipse.
It's not the most outlandish claim I've heard, but it's up there.
Crying Eclipse is a convenient way to dodge a death sentence.
If I have to die, so be it. But if we ignore this threat, others are going to die too.
Tell me exactly what happened.
Weeks ago, during a by the time anyone Nozar didn't
Nozar's not one to be reprimanded this time.
But I couldn't stop thinking about it. None of us are careless out here. Meaning, someone left and Larvik, well, he's always grumbling about officers. But on this, he was too quiet. And after the incident, he started acting. So when I spotted him sneaking out, I found him. And when Larvik mentioned the eclipse, I tried getting the stranger took off, and Larvik lunged at instincts.
Okay.
Why don't you believe him?
We combed the woods. Searched Larvik's bunk. Searched it. Look. Conover's a good man. I don't believe he murdered Larvik in cold blood. But Nozar only listens to facts. And that fact is, Conover killed his fellow sentry. He doesn't deny it, right?
No, but more eclipses
are out there. And considering there's no evidence backing up, well, we can't quite. Nozar's on edge with the upcoming hey, if you find a bunch of eclipse soldiers hatching an evil plot in the woods, please do let us know.
Okay.
The meeting you witnessed.
No. But the
a dozen soldiers have already searched at Conover, and there.
I can see things others can't.
Thank you.
Don't get your hopes up.
And you get down a few more drinks.
Take more than that to keep me down.
I'll just. Try to do this one. Nothing to do with the prologue once we are here, so this is why I'm trying to finish everything in this video. But those question marks will still be there, so I will have to return at some point. That's fine, I guess.
This must be the clearing where Conover says he saw the eclipse. It still is.
I see blood. Lots of it.
This is where Conover killed that guard. Maybe my focus can tell me if there really was a third person here.
That is exactly what I was trying to see. Hey.
I see plenty of tracks from the cart to search party. Not helpful. I should be able to follow them with my focus. Let's see where this leads. Maybe Conover wasn't lying after all.
Oh, they're going the opposite.
across the trail. There's too many machines walking around. Maybe I can pick up the tracks once I'm past them. I'm called on to learn how to ride machines. She must have slashed him.
And ended up dead, so...
should be easy to follow the blood trail.
Doesn't
make focus.
Any sense. Huge creatures like behemoth. Well, we already know Stormbirds are in the game, but those T-Rex monsters, Thunderjaws, I think they're in
the
game.
This game. Climbed up to that cave. With that injury, I'll bet he's on his last legs.
I wouldn't count on it. He's bandaged.
For a diner. This looks like a good place for someone to hide.
Kill the line. Take on a whole garrison. Won't be easy. know Larvik's dead. He hasn't shown at the rendezvous. So either that field guard killed him, or he's lost his mind.
We'll just have to blast our way through the gates.
And then, the Rayab is our only link that's up there. Come on, he's dead too.
We'll track Bez if we have. But first we have to get past Baron Light. Next change of guard, we go back to the
Rosemont. I have to stop them before they hurt anyone else.
I'll put that in the car.
What if Lorovic talks?
What if I stick this knife down your throat?
Save it for the heretics.
Non-lethal too, what the hell? Not even all about dealing with them. Still three more. Might as well loot what we can. Just in case we don't get to visit this lady again.
Someone must have seen something. You think we're clear?
Nope. You are.
Okay. I think we must be clear. Okay.
Trail must have been his. We brought out trying to get here. I was right. Lyad has a focus.
How did you know he had a focus before removing the mask?
Loyal Eclipse. If you're seeing this, it means you've left the city in search of something to follow. Your journey is almost over. Follow the sun beyond the gates of barren light. And bask in the gloom of future conquest. A new empire awaits.
this Vezera visit and crush his new Eclipse Empire before it begins. There's coordinates here, not past Baron Light. Riad's mask should be enough to prove Conover's innocence. Better take it back to Baron Light.
Finally! I wonder why the bus was stuck there.
The Eclipse back in the video. I thought that would be the end of it. Guess I was wrong. I'm not giving up.
You'd pay for that, sons of bitches. At least we unlock that campfire. Right? Revan is easier to go directly. Travel there. Okay. to get to my stash. My stash should be right here. Resources.
Errand. Looks like he's had it here.
Look alive, soldier. She's back.
Aloy! Did you find anything?
Eclipse fugitives were camped out on the other side of the forest. And they were getting ready to fight their way through Barrowmont. You just helped save a lot of lives.
Aloy, you know I believe you. But Nozar, he might not be convinced by your words alone.
If he needs proof, show him that. And tell him the man he's got locked up risked his life to expose and eliminate an Eclipse spy.
Huh. I guess you are his savior. Congratulations, soldier. You're a free man. I'll have you out of there before sunfall. I'll make sure this gets to Nozar.
That's it, then. The end of the Eclipse.
No.
Almost. The trespassers you mentioned, the ones who got through Barren Light weeks ago, their leader's dangerous. And he's out there, in the Forbidden West, building up an army.
Sun and Shadow, you're going out there to stop him, aren't you?
I'm gonna try.
I want to help. I can fight.
I know you can. Once you're out of that cell, you should enjoy your freedom. You've earned it.
Take them out, Sid.
Four skill points. Let's see which one should we do it now. What is this? This could be useful. Which one is this? Whoa. This could be useful too. What's this? Ranged master. This is not that useful. Could be useful. But first, let's go with this one. Of course it's that far. But we are not going that way. We are in this. Right.
Gentlemen.
That's our cue.
Taking the edge off?
Well, it's the end of the world's coming. I don't need to say anything. Now, let me guess. You're in a rush, right? So whatever you need, ask away.
How have you been?
How have things been since I...
Your silent departure. Yeah, not bad. That girl's going strong. Helped the Vod pick up the pieces after the Battle of the Eclipse. And I took a month to bury Earth's reclaim. When I got back, I got the assignment to babysit Wadis on his way to the embassy. I thought that'd be a cakewalk, so of course things went sideways.
You got blindsided. It wasn't your fault.
A couple more of these, maybe I'll believe you.
I was, wondering if you were able to lay Ursa to rest, like you wanted.
Yeah, I did. Just in the crowd to shut up to pay their respects. Half of them owed her a favor, and the other half... owed her their lives. In the end, everybody drank. That's the rowdiest funeral since ever.
Feels like she would have liked that.
Yeah, damn straight. Damn straight. She would have put them all on the table.
Ursa might be his sister, but I don't know much.
Recall
she did.
Only Vod really wants it to happen.
Or did
he said
see
I'm making peace with these tonight.
All the side quests from the
from what
previous
I hear,
game,
really
I kind of forgot. I only remember
Vanasha's
side quest because
so
of
if
the
you
long part
way,
for the naps.
Prepare. Things might get out of the deal fast.
I'll keep that in mind.
And also because we saved that little kid, Ithanin.
Where the Carja dragged all the captives they took from the Forbidden West to the Red Raids. Lucky ones.
Most of the side quests and the
rest were hauled off to the summer.
In this game, I've already forgotten about.
Sacrifice.
Yeah. Tanakh made sure to wreck the place before they chased the Carja out of the West. You can't say I blame you. And now Avad's paying the Azram to rebuild it. No matter how much new stone they put up, it'll still be standing by.
I gotta go.
I better get going.
Right, I'll have to do complicated Aloy things. Maybe just don't disappear completely this time.
No promises.
I guess what I'm really trying to say is, if you ever do need me,
I know where to find you. Hopefully sober next time.
I was gonna say that. Jumpman is no good in a brawl. Much less a straight up fight against lethal machines. First, let's save. It's been a while since I saved, so.
Thick wall of stone between you and the Tanakh out there.
Yes, sir.
What? Are you in charge around here?
Apologies, no. That would be Commander Nozar and Lawan, the second in command. So, what brings Aloy of the Nora to Baron Light?
I'm here for the embassy. I need it to happen so I can head west. But maybe now that Studious Wadis is here, we can finally get things underway.
Yes, the Sun Priest. Walked in practically kicking and screaming behind his escort. Really seems to like his scrolls. But the embassy remains delayed. Commander Nozar has signaled our readiness, but the Tanakh marshals have yet to sound their horn.
All right, fine. Let me through the gates then. I have my own business with them.
I'm sure you do, but I'm afraid I can't. Commander's orders. Normally, the gates are open for any who dare to venture out. Us around salvagers, a few especially grazing Karja, but no one's allowed in or out before an embassy. Now we're open. Once the Tanakh left.
But the embassy.
So what happens at these embassies, exactly?
Mostly trade and negotiation. The Karja offer tribute of food, spices, and gear. In exchange, the Tanakh return personal effects taken from Karja soldiers that fell during the Red Raids. This particular embassy, however, is a special case.
Because the Tanakh, they're handing over some sort of prison, a soldier named Fashaf?
Ah, so you've heard. The exchange has got everyone on edge. You never know if an embassy is going to go well until it's practically over.
You said something about Tanakh's marshals. Who are they?
They're the tribes of elite warriors. Before every embassy, they arrive with a contingent of soldiers from each of their three clans. Then, during the proceedings, they negotiate on behalf of their leader. And by negotiate, I mean stare down our sun priest until they concede. Laib over here came face to face with them for the first time at the last embassy. Came back drenched in his own sweat.
It was hot that day, sir.
It was indeed.
Are we done here?
Where is this Commander Nozon? If he's the one keeping the gates shut, I'll convince him to open them for me.
I'll take you to him, but I have to warn you. The Commander isn't one to break protocol, especially when he's already high-strung.
We'll see about that.
This way.
There's a lot of activity going on around here.
The Tanakh tore down this place during the Red Raids. 2 years of labor, and we still have a long way to go. The work stoppage and change rate nearly halted our rebuilding efforts. But I hear a certain war got them back together.
I was just helping it.
Yes, well, I'm sure Ulven was thrilled.
Maybe not that much. And that Ulven problem we'll deal with when we open the doors.
Stand aside, soldier.
Sir?
There's the commander.
Come on, man. I'm bored of this prairie grassland already. Gonna go out there, find some fun.
How are we to hold the
beaches?
The tribe can't even govern their own people.
Beaches.
What more can you expect from barbarians?
In tropical forests.
Ah. Aloy, was it?
Yes. The one who cleared the valley for you? That one.
We appreciate your service. At least we are ready for the embassy to begin.
Didn't you just give the signal?
Both sides must signal readiness until the Tanakh sound their horn.
Yea, for as the first shall begin.
Shut up. Why the delay?
The Tanakh are a tribe composed of three clans. How many banners do you see?
You're just gonna wait? Go find out what's wrong.
This isn't some forgotten corner of the East where you come from. It's the Forbidden West. If you don't like it, run back to Meridian. Follow the light.
Meridian, I saved, Minnie.
That's right. Nobody walks to the gate until the third clan arrives and the Tanakh's horn has sounded. Not even the savior of Meridian.
I'm going now. Try.
Oh, thanks,
and
but I've waited
stop.
Long enough. It's time to go.
Absolutely not. This embassy depends on diligent adherence to. You shall not!
Keep telling yourself that.
Jesus, man. Learn to ride that machine.
Open the gates, please.
cannot let her through that gate! That is a direct order!
Sorry, can't do it.
I'm asking nicely.
Yeah, or there will be bloodshed.
Hey, Bar.
Hi, Aaron.
What's happening?
You know, the usual. Aloy wants something. People
open
try to stand in her way. It's not
gonna
work.
That's it. Arrest her.
I'd like to see you try.
Supporting fire?
Yeah, locked and loaded.
Hey! Nose off! You stupid bastard. You think you got the authority to keep that door shut in the savior of Meridian's face? What do you think Sun King Avad is gonna do when he hears what you did? Promote you, huh? Let it through, boys. Saving the world.
Forgot something back in Meridian?
Look, Paul.
Doesn't matter. Made it just in time.
Take your machine mount with you. I'm not gonna override another mount just for you.
This tribe with Murat told us about the Tanakh. We need their permission to go west.
Yeah, well, I figured it'd be nice if they weren't trying to kill me the whole time.
But this embassy hasn't started yet. We're just gonna barge in?
Yes.
No more politics. No more delays.
Oh, well. Now at least you have some backup.
I guess I do. We'll see how it goes.
I'm just gonna barge in and show them who's boss.
That is the line between east and west. Cross it and die.
Hold on now. Let's take it easy.
None may walk this valley until our signal sounds. That was our accord with the Karja.
I'm not Karja. I came here on my own to ask for rite of passage.
But they opened the gate for you, did they not? What is the meaning of this violation?
Why send a child? Do they want to harm you or not?
The Karja can't be trusted. This is no...
Forget the Karja. This has nothing to do with them. We need to go west to save lives. Maybe even yours.
The only lives you can save are your own. By turning back. Now.
Hold! She's telling the truth about one thing. She's not Karja. She's a Nora from the Savage East. And if she seeks to save lives, should we not listen? Let me speak. One last favor for a fellow marshal.
Those swords, you can. Double hilted.
Fearless, red headed woman.
Kinda reminds me of Kotal Khan's sword.
Just it.
I am unyielding Fashad, once of the Karja High Command, last of the Army of the Setting Sun.
Well, Fashad, Avad gave me a message for you, that he waits for you in Meridian where you belong.
Avad always was. Now I'm even more curious about you, knowing that you have the confidence of the Sun King. But such an association with the Karja will be against you. It's a rough match with me. As you can see, tensions are high. This embassy is a delicate threat. They're about to return me to the Sun King, a gesture that might help soothe painful grievances. Unheralded.
I'm not here to cause trouble. I just need to go west.
So you say. I might be able to help. I need to go far. Along with some assurance that I...
Tattoos.
I've never seen markings like those on a Karja before.
The Karja see ink as decoration. But the Tanakh is much more. a litany of deeds, a record of vanquished enemies.
Looks like you've vanquished quite a few.
And I've fought my share of battles. But I feel that my life, like my workings, is only half complete. This side shows my martial deeds. Before I die, I'd like to see the other half marked with the laws of peace.
You and the Tanakh.
How did you come to be among the Tanakh?
It's quite a story, but not a quick one. Though I suppose neither of us is going anywhere before we listen to things. I'm sure you won't hear it.
Tell me.
I guess we have time.
Very well. I marched with Sun King Jiran's raiders when they came west, hoping to moderate their worst advances. Afraid. They committed unspeakable atrocities, stirring the demonic direction. When the clans overran our forward encampment at Cinnabar Sands, I stayed behind to help the last stragglers evacuate. I was taken prisoner. I didn't make it easy for my captors, mind you. Paid me back in kind to return to the cabin. I lost so much blood on the way that I was white as a corpse when they threw me before Chief Akaro. I thought I was dead for sure, so I resorted to desperate measures.
Desperate measures?
So when you met the Tanakh chief, you did something desperate.
Stabbed him?
I kept my ears open as the Tanakh dragged me along, and I heard mutterings about a kind of trial by combat. When they flung me at Akaro's feet, I demanded this right, called the Kurut, thinking that by winning I could request a boon, my life, even my freedom. The other Tanakh howled, but Akaro stared them down, and then his gaze fell upon me. Looked at me, appreciated my ingenuity. He allowed me to participate in the Kurut. Little did I know what I was in for.
You said the Kurut is a Tanakh trial by combat.
Yes. But it is no ordinary trial. It doesn't pit men against each other, at least not directly. Instead, the combatants fight machines in a great arena, and only the strongest survive. It is an easy thing to stare down the charge of a machine while hundreds around you scream for blood.
I know more about that than you would think.
Listen.
Then you have my respect.
This has been wonderful.
Like you, I lived through it to claim my prize. I had hoped for freedom.
I have work to do.
But that was not offer. Only service to the chief.
Service to the chief. Come on, man!
The winners of the Kurut must serve the chief as his marshals.
You mentioned that word before. What does it mean?
The word itself refers to a kind of protective spirit from the ancient past. In practice, Marshals are Akaro's woven lawgivers, part magistrate, part judge, part executioner. I won my place among their ranks and served as honored men, but many Tanakhs just spat on the ground when I walked by. And they did, until I started forcing them to the ground to lower their faces in.
I guess that's one way to deal with it.
As you may have noticed, violence is the native tongue of the Tanakh. To survive, you must master it. The truth is, though, the cars are speaking to you. More than you should. You can bring it to my brain.
So which tribe are you?
So then, are you still Karja?
Part of me. There is much to admire about the Tanakh. And I've heard stories about what it was. Three clans, always Karo and the Marshals of Manifested. Who knows?
Please finish this.
The Karja talk about Hakaro.
The Karja feel compelled to demonize him, if only because it is true that he was. When I was first taken before him, he is no bloodthirsty tyrant. I think that if you were fortunate enough to meet him, you would find that he only wants the best I will do speak to him. So, that's my story, the Karja need to know.
Yeah. The way you talk about the Tanakh, that. Are you glad to be going back to Moria?
Oh, I'll admit that I wouldn't mind sleeping more. sipping wines, but I have another goal. As someone who knows the Tanakh and the Kaja, I'm in a unique position. If Sun King of Ad is amenable, my hope is to establish.
The Tanakh don't seem that peaceful.
They're not, as a rule. Chief Akaro knows that survival often requires change. And if that change means putting aside.
Not it.
You asked why I need rite of passage. I'll tell you. You won't like my answer. 6 months ago, the world almost ended. That threat still exists.
We just lost that time, by the way.
It's getting worse every day. Much worse. Calling down storms, poisoning the water, enraging the machines. The source of it all has gone west. And I'm the only one who can stop it.
I've seen the signs. And I've heard tales of incredible occurrences in the ring. An army of demons vanquished by a red-haired champion. So I'm glad to be there. The burden of your task is written across your face clearer than any mark of mine. I'll grant you this. To serve as proof of your right to travel into Tanakh lands. The task's so important. It's just the two of you. Take it from one who aspires to be a diplomat. Allies are essential. Chief Akaro knows the West better than anyone. He can be able to help. He can be intimidating to others, but don't let that deceive you.
Maybe. If anything.
Your choice. You can find him at his palace. Past the mountains to the southwest. Tell him I sent you. And he'll listen to
Talk!
You.
The Sky Clan's banner.
Marshals. It wasn't easy, but I brought the Sky Clan with me.
And the commander?
No. I could only convince a few. He isn't yet aware we left.
We have banners from all three clans. If there are fewer from the Sky Clan, it can't be helped.
He's right. Sound the horn.
Let's go home.
Not all Tanakh can stomach the idea of parlaying with the country. But enough have come for us to begin.
Then I'll be on my way.
No. The other marshals will not permit it. You wanted safe passage, you have it. After the embassy.
Why the rush? Hades is not going anywhere. At the most, he'll corrupt maybe a couple dozen forests.
The Kaja have opened the gates.
As much as I want to the Forbidden West, you might as well do it legally instead of being a fugitive.
As the sun rises over a land at war, so too can it set over a land at peace. Today is such.
Hear me, marshals! You who claim to be Tanakh!
Madama, Chief Akaro's biggest mistake. I should have killed.
You have forgotten that our people were born in blood. The blood of the Kaja. Instead, you pledge your spears to a chief who conspires with the enemy. Akaro has betrayed us. The embassy is proof. And all of you marshals are his accomplices. For this, I condemn you to death.
You'll need more than toothless threats to intimidate us. Exile.
Riding machines! Where'd they learn to do that?
Silence.
Vashav! Come with us now, or not at all!
Archer! Light them up!
Supposed to be a peaceful summit. That god bitch is gonna steal every fucking second of my back. Okay, she's not mod. But still. Bitch!
Lancers!
Get off that fucking machine and fight me!
Get ready!
If you have the balls.
Stick to cover!
Archers on the ridge!
Here they come!
Move in!
pain subsided.
Yeah, give me. There's the ammo. Nice.
See the rider?
Here comes the ammo.
She's hurt.
Another one fall. Check on them.
Okay, wait. Shooting at me.
Thank you.
Yes, I do. Piece of shit. I said, give me a goddamn minute. Bitch, aren't you?
Stuck with Aaron. For now.
I'll take you back to the fort.
Still trying to sort out this mess. Seems like the Tanakh have a civil war in their hands.
It sounds about right. The Martians weren't expecting Magala to attack.
And the entire Karja delegation was slain. Nozar, Vuadis, Vashav, a massacre. What will you do now?
I have to head west. Hopefully this rite of passage is still good. For what I'm after, I'll cross all of Tanakh's territory if I have to.
Then you have a long road ahead of you. This is only the threshold of the Forbidden West. The Tanakh's true domain lies over the mountains that border Plainsong, home of the Utaru tribe.
This isn't Tanakh's territory?
All that out there? That's no man's land. It was supposed to be neutral ground, though obviously this Regala ignored that. Her rebels approached from the north, with all those machines they were riding. They must have made camp up that way.
The rebels were riding bristlebacks. There were bristlebacks in the Daunt.
Are you saying the rebels let them into the Daunt? How would that even be possible?
I don't know. But it's worth looking into.
While you're at it, there were a number of Karja and Osiran who went out there before the gates were shut for the embassy. Maybe you could check in on them. See if they're all right.
I can keep an eye out. Is there a tall neck somewhere nearby?
A tall neck? There's that one, over there, near the Utara border. But why...
It's hard to explain. It'll help me get the lay of the land.
If you say so. Is there anything else I can tell you before you go?
Back in a friend, Regala. I'm gonna show my spear so deep up her ass, it'll come out through her fucking mouth.
Vashav called Regala a rival. Someone that's knocked chief should have killed.
Yeah, I reckon he should have. She's obviously a huge threat. Her attack was coordinated and precise. Until you got in her way, that is.
They knew the lay of the land. And they knew Vashav was going to be handed over at the embassy. If the Tanakh weren't expecting her, she must have spent months gathering an army in secret.
They had to have made camp nearby. Somewhere they could lie low until the perfect moment to strike.
Vashav.
About Vashav.
The man was taken captive by the Tanakh. Survived for years out in the west, only to die just short of the Sundom. It's a cruel end for a good soldier.
There was more he wanted to do. He spoke of advocating for lasting peace between the Karja and Tanakh.
Too late for that now.
What will happen to him?
His body will be carried back to Meridian. As a cousin of the Sun King, he will be accorded official rights and buried with honor. No soldier could ask for more.
Too bad about Rosar and Vuadis.
At least Nozar went down fighting. As for the Sun Priest,
yeah.
Well, No one deserves to go out that way.
That is in the back.
I'll make sure they're given proper funeral rites. It's the least I can do.
Do you think the Karjan will take action against Regala? Seems like you'd have common ground with the Tanakhs.
An expedition of the Karja army into the west could be taken as the start of another invasion. Sun King Avad won't risk it. That said, we can't allow ourselves to be caught unaware by an attack like that again.
You said the Tanakh's lands are far to the west. What can I expect to find between here and there?
Well, as I mentioned, you've got a stretch of wilderness known as No Man's Land, and then new Taru farmlands. Past that are the Tanakh. Their territory is split into three clans. Desert, lowland, and sky.
Right. I saw their banners at the embassy.
The desert clan is closest. Ooh, vicious lot. Where everyone else sees an inhospitable wasteland, they see a challenge to dominate. Somewhere beyond the desert is the tribe's capital and the territories of the other two clans.
You don't sound certain.
I've only heard the stories. During the Red Raids, the Karja army tried to push into Tanakh territory, but the United Clans rose up against them, forced them all the way back to the Daunt.
So no one except the Tanakh will know what's beyond the desert.
Maybe the scholars do, back in Meridian. All those scrolls have to be filled with something, right?
You mentioned the Utari tribe. Their lands are between here and the Tanakh further west?
That's right. Plainsong is their home. They're a peaceful bunch, at least compared to the Tanakh. More taken to farming than fighting.
It's hard to imagine a bunch of farmers surviving in the Forbidden West.
Make no mistake, they have a fierceness all their own. When the Karja were pushed back during the Red Raids, their warriors chased ours through the burning fields of Plainsong. The Sun King has made several overtures of peace to them as well, but so far, they've declined.
If they're so peaceful, why decline?
Don't know. I heard they have their own troubles to deal with. Something about a food shortage. You'd think that'd make them open to trade, but no. They just want to be left alone.
This area is no man's land.
That it is. The Tanakh used to attack anyone past Baron Light on sight, but after Avad overthrew the Mad Sun King, he reached out to the other tribes to offer reconciliation. The Tanakh agreed to a neutral border zone as part of the peace talks. Karja and Asuram have been striking out into the area ever since.
Now, it seems like Regala and her rebel army have moved in.
Well, I'd never call No Man's Land safe, even in the best of times. The ancient ruins of the southwest are a testament to that. Remnants of some forgotten war.
One last question.
You said there were others who went out when the gates were open before. Like who?
Well, in addition to the salvagers that just went through, there were a couple of other parties of Osirum delvers. Even saw two Karja scholars trekking southwest with an Osirum crew. Not sure if they're exceptionally brave or just foolhardy.
I'd need to be on my way.
Then I wish you luck. The gates will always be open to you should you wish to return.
Okay.
And don't worry about your friends. We'll get them patched up.
I appreciate it.
Sun, watch over you, Eloy. I hope you find what you're looking for.
So I guess this guy is the next in line in the place of commander. Whatever knows I was. Commander, guard, captain, whatever. Three. time to pick all of this up.
From the spire should lead to Silence and Hades. And just maybe, back to Asgard. More days out there. The blight, the storms, recalls, machine riders. We'll have to push through. Find a way to fix the world. Take the most forward.
Be others. Silence is the only person she knows that can control machines besides her. Even that guy,
it's from my stash,
that Eclipse guy from the previous game, even he could control machines to some extent, not all. I mean, he did make her fight a behemoth. Now we have 3 full bars of health. That's good.
Good spot to test the shield, eh? Now we come down, we can glide.
I hate killing foxes, but sometimes it's necessary, especially to craft. See that base canister when off the edge. So, where's the tonic? Ah, there. Should we override a charger or something and let's go to the tonic first? Or should we keep it simple and close the stream right now? I see a tonic from here. Is it the same one? Might as well explore. tomorrow. But now let's call it a day. I mean, after that whole embassy disaster, who wouldn't want to? Let's call it a day with this one. I'll be back again tomorrow morning with the stream. First order of business is getting the tall neck. Tall necks are just like the viewpoint towers in Assassin's Creed, or the radio towers in Far Cry 3 and 4. Climbing up them gives us a whole survey of the land, I should say. And after the tall neck is done, we can do these three quests in tomorrow's stream. So keep liking, sharing, and subscribing. And as always, stay tuned, stay safe, stay healthy. Take care.